So if you have a website, then you probably heard in recent years you need an SSL or TLS certificate if you want your website to look legitimate and trustworthy. Especially if you're selling something online or you allow users to create accounts with your company. SSL certificate can also boost your search engine rankings. Here I have one website I'm helping with, and as you can see, without a valid certificate, this non-profitable website is marked as not secure. Let's make it secure and safe to browse. There are many paid options to get one of these certificates, but there are very few free options. Unfortunately, my hosting provider does not provide free SSL integration. If you know reliable hosting service with free SSL integration in Ireland, please let me know down in the comments. This integration by hosting provider is usually accompanied by an automated process designed to overcome manual creation, validation, signing, installation, and renewal of certificates. There is a worldwide list of hosting providers supporting trusted certification authority called Let's Encrypt, which offers certificates at no charge, so check it out. Link is in the description below. Fortunately, my hosting provider does support uploading custom certificates. Before I discovered how to create these free Let's Encrypt certificates, I have used SSL for free web server to do it for me. This service used to be free forever. But, until it was acquired by ZeroSSL in 2020. You can still create free SSL certificates via SSL for free or ZeroSSL. But, only 3 certificates for one domain. Then you have to pay. This tutorial will demonstrate how to create and install free Let's Encrypt certificate in manual mode on Windows using free software called ACME Client. No coding required. To download one of these clients, go to letsencrypt.org, navigate to Documentation, and to ACME Client Implementations. One of the Windows free simple clients is WinACME. Go ahead and download it. Extract downloaded zip file to your favorite location. Then open WACSEXE file as administrator and allow to run the application in user account control prompt. Once the WinACME is running, there are a few options to select.
No coding.
Start with creating certificate with full options. Type letter M, M for manual, and hit enter. Confirm manual input and type number 2 and hit enter. Next, enter your domain name, without www, and also with www prefix, separated by a comma, your domain name, not mine, and hit enter. Then press enter to accept these domain names. Next, select option 6, so type number 6, and hit enter. You are going to create verification, text record, manually at your hosting later on. Next, select option 2, so type number 2, to pick RSA key, and hit enter. Next, select option 2, so type number 2, to save keys as a PEM files, and hit enter. Next, type your favorite location to store your keys. What is the letter of your favorite computer drive? Type your letter, not mine, followed by colon symbol and reverse solidus, and hit enter. In the next option, I decided not to use a password. Pressed enter. Next, select option 5, so type number 5, and hit enter. No additional store steps. Next, select option 4, so type number 4, and hit enter. No additional installation steps, nearly there. You can read terms of service later on. Type letter N, N, for no, and press enter. Next, select type letter, Y. Y for yes to agree with the terms, and press enter. In the next step, enter your email for notifications. Your email, and press enter. Under the gray box, I am writing my email. After that, I pressed enter. In the next step, you are going to create text record at your website hosting, to prove your ownership of this domain. This will be the name of the text record, underscore, ACME, hyphen, challenge, dot, followed by your domain. Your domain, not mine. And this line will be the content of the record. You are going to copy and paste all the characters in between the quotes later on. Keep the WinACME window opened. Now go to your hosting provider and log into your account. At the control panel, you want to find DNS records of your particular domain. Your control panel will look different, but find DNS records of your domain. To prove the ownership of your domain, you need to create a new DNS record. DNS record type must be TXT, text type. Select TXT. Then go back to WinACME window you left opened and copy and paste the record name. Underscore, ACME, hyphen, challenge. The end needs to finish with your domain. Then again, go back to WinACME window you left opened and copy and paste the characters of the content line. I copied the characters including the quotes. That did not work with the control panel I have, as you can see. So on the second try I deleted the quotes. Depending on your control panel, try if the quotes are needed or not. Once newly DNS text record is created, go back to WinACME window you left opened, and press Enter. But, not too soon. If you do it too soon, verification might fail, because DNS provider needs a little more time to publish and synchronize the changes. Wait a little. Once synchronized, proceed and retry to verify newly created DNS record. To retry, type number 1, and press Enter. Wait for validation. Once new DNS record is validated, go back to hosting provider, and delete this new DNS TXT record. It is needed for once-off validation. Go back to WinACME window, and press Enter, after you have deleted the record. Shortly after, new validation details will be created. This time for the domain which includes www. Once again go to your hosting provider, to DNS records, and create a new TXT DNS record. This time for the domain which includes www. Your domain, not mine. Then again, go back to WinACME window you left opened and copy and paste the characters of the content line. Content line, of www version of the domain. Wait a little. DNS provider needs time to publish and synchronize the changes. Once synchronized, go back to WinACME window you left opened and press Enter. Or retry by typing number 1 to verify newly created DNS record. Once new DNS record is validated, go back to hosting provider and delete this new DNS TXT record. It is needed for once-off validation. Go back to WinACME window, and press Enter, after you have deleted the record. One last standby. Congratulations, your SSL TLS certificate is created, and your PEM files are stored at the location you specified earlier. You don't need to specify the user at the last question, so I have entered letter N. N for no. Now it's time to quit WinACME. You've created SSL certificate under 10 minutes. Here, I have my newly created PEM files, but before I can upload them to my hosting provider, I need to save them with a specific file extension. My hosting provider does support uploading custom certificates with CRT extension and KEY extension. Perhaps your hosting provider supports PEM files. In this case, renaming is not necessary. starting with file named your domain hyphen key dot pem. Open this file with Windows Notepad. If needed, click on More Apps. I am saving this file as private.key file. private.key. In order to save this file as key file, click on Save as Type option and select All Files. Next, I am going to save the file named as your domain hyphen crt.pem. Open this file in Windows Notepad. I am saving this file as certificate.crt file. certificate.crt. In order to save this file as CRT file, click on Save as Type option and select All Files. Lastly, I am going to save the file named as your domain hyphen chain.pem. Open this file in Windows Notepad. I am saving this file as ca_bundle.crt file. ca_bundle.crt. In order to save this file as CRT file, click on Save as Type option and select All Files. Now I am ready to upload these three files to my hosting provider. At the control panel, you want to find website configuration, SSL or TLS settings for your particular domain. If needed, enable SSL or TLS. Yes, I am here to install certificate. And I want choose the certificate file that contains the certificate. I am ready to upload file previously saved as certificate.crt. I am also ready to upload file previously saved as private.key. Lastly, I am ready to upload CA certificate. File previously saved as ca_bundle.crt. I can't wait to upload the certificate file that contains CA certificate. Previously saved as ca_bundle.crt. Hooray! I love green ticks. No, you did not hear green bits. That would be weird. But does it work? After a few minutes, I have to finally try the domain with HTTPS. And bingo! Padlock means that we have safe and secure website. SSL certificate installed. Free valid certificate from Let's Encrypt, a non-profit certificate authority. It will need to be renewed every 90 days. Yay! But don't go anywhere yet. Not that fast. We need to redirect non-HTTPS website to our newly secured HTTPS website. Jump to file manager of that particular website at your hosting provider. Find the HTTP folder and locate .htaccess file. In the previous step, testing Padlock, I presumed you have uploaded your website to HTTPS folder at your hosting. First, I am going to download the copy of mentioned .htaccess file. Then I am going to rename original .htaccess file in case I will need it later. Then, I want to open that file in Windows Notepad. You can find and copy this redirect text in the description below this video. You can have blank and empty htaccess file, or perhaps this file might already contain some text. Just copy and paste this new redirect text at the top. Save this htaccess file as all files document. And don't forget to include the dot in front of the file name. Once saved, upload this newly updated htaccess file to HTTP folder of this particular domain at your hosting provider. Finally, we can test the redirection from HTTP website to HTTPS website. So we have successfully redirected traffic from HTTP website to HTTPS website, and also successfully created free SSL certificate. That's it for this time, and I hope that this video was helpful. Thanks for watching and browse safe.